Guys, vibe coding is a scam. And before you spend thousands of dollars and countless hours like I did, please just watch this video so you can understand what vibe coding is and what it isn't. Let's start by defining what is vibe coding. Guys, vibe coding is simply a way of writing code and building software in plain language. You write the words, AI writes the code. And quite frankly, the first time you experience vibe coding, you open up a software and start writing code using plain language, your mind is gonna be blown. And in the marketing world, we call this that aha moment. It's that moment where you realize, holy crap, I just asked it to do something and it did it. Your mind is gonna be blown. It's gonna be blown. But there's a dirty secret. We'll get to that in a moment. My parents, when I was younger, put me into coding and I hated it. I didn't want to learn JSON and JavaScript and CSS. I didn't want to learn any of that. And in retrospect now, I somewhat regret that. You know, I'm a creator and software is one of the most scalable business opportunities in the world. But I didn't want to learn a new language. And quite frankly, I've had so many great ideas over the years. Have you had great ideas? Have you said, wow, I wish that existed, but I don't know how to code and I don't have $250,000 to pay a software developer to build the software. So you're stuck. Guys, that is the promise of vibe coding. The promise of vibe coding is so powerful. It's this idea that anything that you can imagine, you can create. Everyone can be a coder now. All you need to do is have an idea. And that is a really compelling idea and it sucks a lot of people in. And you know, listen, I'm a marketer, and in the marketing world, we ruin everything. We ruin everything. We know psychology, we know how to manipulate people, we know how to get you to click and convert and create traffic. That's what we do. And that promise of your million-dollar idea, you can bring into reality, all you need to do is have the idea, is really powerful in vibe coding right now. And so, what we wanna do is kind of explain that there is a dirty secret behind that, but also if you stick around to the end, I'm gonna explain what vibe coding is actually really good for, because it's probably not what you've been sold. It's really good at a few things, and these are not the things that are being sold to you right now from marketers, okay? So anyway, I was stuck. I wanted to build software, but I didn't want to learn how to code. Along comes vibe coding earlier this year. And companies like Replit and Lovable exploded in popularity. I mean, Replit went from just a couple million in annual recurring revenue to $100 million in annual recurring revenue over just a short period of time. Vibe coding has exploded. Again, it's so powerful, this idea that anyone can write software. Anybody can solve their own problems. Anybody can create the next Facebook. But here's the problem, guys. The back end is completely flawed. Let me put it this way. Have you ever dated a girl that was really hot, but she was completely insane? You know what I'm talking about. If you've ever done that, put it in the comments below. Guys, that is what vibe coding is. It is that super hot, super sexy girl that you've met at the bar, and what you realize after a short period of time that she's completely insane. It's all front end. It's makeup, it's clothing, it's push-up bras. But as soon as you get her, as soon as you start to learn, you're like, well, as soon as you get to morning coffee, you're like, what have I done? What if I hitched my train to? Guys, that is what vibe coding is like. Now, again, if you stick around, I'm gonna explain exactly why it's flawed and why she's so crazy, but I'm also gonna explain to you the value. So hang tight, hold that thought, okay? Because I've had a personal experience with this. No, not the crazy hot girl. Well, yeah, that too. But I've had a personal experience with these AI vibe coding tools. I hopped on, I got started with a program and immediately was blown away. Blown away, I was like, holy crap, I was able to, within an hour, build out what looks like a pretty nice looking software. I had this really cool idea and I was able to kind of build it really quickly. And here's the thing though. As I started to develop my idea over the course of the next several days, I was being nickel and dimed tokens every time I started to try to refine things. And what I noticed is that I would fix something somewhere, but it would just erase something somewhere else. And it was so frustrating. Have you had this experience with vibe coding? The more you try to tweak and optimize your app or your software, the more insane it gets. It's like, dude, I just commanded you to fix it over here. I prompted you the right way, but you just screwed up. You fixed this page, but you screwed up that page. Or something very simple like, I want the color of the buttons to be yellow, not blue. And it's like, okay, I'll rework your entire website to be blue. And it's like, what are you doing? Or you say, hey, I want you to, I just logged in, but I don't see my name in the database. Oh, okay, well, we'll completely change the database. And it's like, no, it's, what are you doing? And we're gonna explain exactly why that's happened, because through this process, I became frustrated. And again, if you hold that thought, I'm gonna explain to you where these tools have a very real place in the market, but we'll get there. What I do wanna do is just briefly explain why this chick is so crazy, why vibe coding is in its current state a scam the way it's being presented to us, okay? And I wanna give a shout out to one of the community members, Accessible Bits. Shout out to Accessible Bits. I had a really good conversation with Accessible via email, where we went back and forth with some of the pros and cons to vibe coding. And he really laid down the technical aspects of what's happening behind the scenes and why it's not working. So shout out. And by the way, guys, if you have some great comments and you've liked and subscribed, all that good stuff, thank you. Leave your comments below, because I read every comment. And some of the comments are really profound, and they're helping me and the rest of the men out there that want to survive and thrive during this AI world, that we want to remain relevant, respected, financially free. The comments below help a lot more than you probably know. A lot more than you probably know. There's some really good comments. And frankly, if you have a really good comment that's database-backed and it really adds to the conversation, I will pin your comment. I've done it in the past. I will do it in the future. So anyway, shout out to Accessible Bits. Why does vibe coding break down? Why is it that the front end looks hot, but the back end is crazy? So a lot of these tools are just straight up crippled by design. They only read 250 lines of code per file at a time. And the companies do this in order to save money on token usage. But here's the problem. What it does is it ends up like completely overriding previous versions of your written code. Some softwares, guys, a pretty complex software, could have hundreds of thousands of lines, millions of lines of code. And if your software is only reading the past 250, it's like having a conversation with someone with dementia, or maybe a president, but let's not go there. It's like having a conversation with someone that can't remember what they had for breakfast. How can you possibly build something real with that? And some of these programs have really weak agentics. So they might write the code fast, but without any thought. And let me put it like this way. Do you know people, it's like this. It's like you're in high school and you didn't read the book, and so you just wrote a bunch of words on a piece of paper, but there's no substance to it. Does that strike home with anyone? Does anyone hear me on that? Smash the like button if you've ever done that. If you've ever had a large essay to write, but you didn't read the book, that is what a lot of these vibe coding softwares are like. They write a bunch of words, but it's, you know, Stephen King has this concept that I just love. It's that great writing is writing something, removing half of it, and then removing half of it again. It's, you know, when it's funny, when you're in high school, it's about how can I write more words to fill up more paper? But as you get older and more experienced, and you know, me and in copywriting, it's not about words, it's about content. So when I'm writing, for example, my newsletter, AIupdate.ai, you should subscribe, it's completely free, AIupdate.ai. Know what other people don't now, AIupdate.ai, check it out. But when I'm writing the newsletter, I write it, and then I remove half of it, and then I remove half of it again. After I've written it, I remove words, because I don't want to waste your time. If I was just using chat, and this is, I don't want to go off on a tangent here, but this is what a lot of AI writing is. It's all AI slop. I'll post a link. I recorded a video about AI slop, and now it's overtaking the internet. Over 50% of the internet now is AI slop. And what people are doing is they're just taking an idea from ChatGPT, copying and pasting it. But the problem with these AI tools is they just write words. They don't write substance. Does that make sense? I've become really sick. Honestly, it makes me sick because I love AI for a lot of reasons. But you know what it's doing is it's making us lazy. There's this idea I think that people have, and I'm sorry, I'm going off on a tangent here. But if you feel me, if you hear me, say so in the comments. The problem right now with AI is that people think that they're working smarter, not harder. But they're not working smarter, they're working lazier. Do you understand what I'm saying? You're just asking ChatGPT a prompt, copy and pasting it. And that, my friends, is happening all over the internet. It's happening everywhere, but it's also, and which is adding to the noise, but this is also the problem with vibe coding. Is you're not working smarter, you're working lazier. And there is a big difference. I am all for working smarter. I'm all for it. 1000% on board. What I'm not on board for is working lazier. And I think that that is the trap a lot of people are falling into when it comes to AI. What else? So the vibe coding, duplicate functions in the same file. It's writing version 2 files instead of updating old files. I found this a lot when I was using vibe coding to create databases. It would just create like duplicate files and then it got confused. And again, this is because it's not remembering what it just did 5 minutes ago. It doesn't remember what it ate for breakfast. And there's broken imports. It's referencing files or functions that maybe got deleted or never existed. It's completely filled with security flaws. If you're asking people to submit, you know, logins and passwords and any sort of personal identification, it's all at risk. In fact, there was a time earlier this year, this is a little bit of a side note, but there's a time earlier this year where people's personal ChatGPT conversations were just searchable on Google. This is the kind of stuff that's happening. By the way, if you're looking for a good career to get into, cybersecurity, you cannot go wrong there. You cannot go wrong in cybersecurity. It's gonna become more and more and more important. We're talking about people putting humanoid robots in their homes. You best believe they're gonna wanna make sure that they're private and secure. Regardless, the biggest problem I think that we're having with vibe coding now is there is this promise, there is this scam that everybody is going to be able to write amazing software and everyone's going to be able to become a millionaire. And I don't see that happening. Listen, vibe coding is the worst now that it's ever going to be. And it certainly could get better. We could have a utopia. It's possible. But, you know, it's also possible we're living through Theranos revisited. And if you're not familiar with Theranos, Theranos was a company that said, hey, if you send us a small vial of blood, we can perform thousands of different medical tests on just one small vial of blood. But what they were doing is they were completely fabricating everything. It was a Ponzi scheme. It all upended. So I'm all about having vision, having a big vision and a big goal, but that's not necessarily a promise that it is going to happen. Does that make sense? I hope so. So I've talked about all the scam and how marketers are ruining vibe coding and how you're being sold something that is not actually tangible reality. Let me at least leave you with a positive note. A positive note on what this vibe coding is actually good for, and it is useful for, because in my experience in vibe coding, I learned a lot, and I'm thankful for that. But I want to make sure that you go in with the proper context, that you don't think that, you know, you're going to create the next Instagram through vibe coding. It's not going to happen. But there are some positive takeaways here. So one of the things that I think vibe coding can be very useful for is solving small internal problems within your organization, okay? So throughout your organization there, maybe you have submission forms or you have internal processes and you don't really want to create a new software. Maybe you want to assess projects or you want to assess performance. There might be small things you want to do, but you don't want to pay for an expensive software. Vibe coding is a way of creating small, quick, answerable solutions. That is a place that you can be rewarded is by using vibe coding to create small internal solutions, okay? Vibe coding as education, I think, is very powerful. If you have considered, hey, do I want to get into coding? Do I want to learn how to code? Do I want to understand what's happening on both the front end and the back end of software? Vibe coding is a really, really good way to get in. Because at the end of the day, coding and learning these new languages is really tough. It's really tough. There's a large barrier to entry. But if you can pop open a program like Replit and start writing code and looking at the back end and solving problems, it is kind of like solving a puzzle. Now, are you going to build the next Instagram? Probably not. But it does give you the ability to speak the language and understand database schema and TXT and API integration. So you can start to speak some more language and be more well-informed, which at the end of the day, I think is a really, really important thing in this period of time. So think about it as education. Think about it investing in your own knowledge, your interest, you're curious. Pique that curiosity with vibe coding. Vibe coding is also going to be a great way to test your ideas. So maybe you have an idea, test simple ideas, mind you. If you have, I'll give you an example. There is a software that's completely exploded. It's doing like 30 million in ARR right now. And it's such a simple idea. It's take a picture of your food and it will tell you, we'll use AI to give you the estimated nutritional information, calories, carbs, saturated fats, all that. And this company has completely exploded. It's very simple. Take a picture, use AI to give you an idea. And I think these types of ideas are fantastic. So for example, maybe you have the garage seller evaluation tool. I actually held a garage sale the other day and I was using ChatGPT taking pictures. This is actually a great idea. You can see all this, but this would be a really good idea of something that you could vibe code. The garage seller AI tool, take a picture of something on the, and then it gives you an estimated value of the item and it gives you some tips on how to haggle it or hassle it. That's actually the great idea. You can take that one for free, guys, just for following the channel. So anyway, simple ideas. You don't want to have all these complex processes. The more complicated it is, the less likely it's going to work in the vibe coding world. And by the way, just be prepared, because if you have an idea that works, that is working, you're probably going to need to hire a software engineer at some point to come in and really clean it up. And one of the ideas that I was working on, I was considering doing this, so I went to Fiverr. I'm looking at $500, $1,000 to bring someone on to fix some code. So just understand that those developers are still going to play a value. And by the way, if you are in software development or engineering, I know there's a lot of doom and gloom right now, and there's reason to be concerned. However, understand that the more people are vibe coding, the more opportunities there are going to be for you to make money. Guys, the technology is definitely going to improve, but don't give up. It's gonna improve, but don't give up and don't have an unrealistic expectation of what is possible, okay? I hope this video helps set some realistic expectations. I just really appreciate you being here and subscribing and all that. I'm bringing you fresh videos 6 days a week. And if you like this video, I think you will really like yesterday's video. We covered GM, who is firing thousands and thousands and thousands of employees for robotics, for automation, and maybe some other reasons that you didn't necessarily expect. Check out yesterday's video, and I'll see you there, boys. See ya, peace.